Deals and deadlines with the nation's debt limit on the line. It's a busy week in Congress with lingering uncertainty over the fate of the president's infrastructure bill. We'll talk with Congressman Andre Carson and Congressman Greg Pence, plus Congressman Jim Banks from Fort Wayne pushing back against the president's vaccine mandates. All that and the latest on the legal battle over the governor's emergency powers. Now on this week's edition of In Focus.
Every single initial ruling. Did this one come as a surprise?
I wouldn't use the word surprise.
Big developments this week in the legal battle between the governor and the General Assembly. A judge siding with the legislature, saying they do have the power to call themselves into session during a public health emergency to review the governor's emergency orders, a move that Governor Holcomb had challenged. We'll talk about that later today with our panel. We're also following a number of headlines in the nation's capital. Congress reaching a deal on the debt ceiling, but still at odds over big parts of the president's agenda. This is President Biden and federal health officials defend their plans to get more Americans vaccinated against COVID-19. Jesse Turnor has the latest.
I've tried everything in my power to get people vaccinated.
Nearly 190 million Americans are fully vaccinated against COVID-19. And President Biden hopes the U.S. soon adds more children to that number.
There is no other way to beat the pandemic than to get the vast majority of Americans vaccinated.
Those 12 and older can get the Pfizer vaccine, but the company just asked the FDA to approve the shot for kids 5 to 11. Americans 18 and older can get the Moderna and Johnson & Johnson vaccines.
We have to beat this thing.
CDC Director Dr. Rochelle Walensky says vaccinations are important to not only protect kids from the pandemic, but also the flu.
Children, especially under 5, who are at risk of severe complications from the flu.
For older Americans, the Biden administration is also working to increase COVID booster shots.
We estimate that 4 million Americans have now rolled up their sleeves and gotten a booster shot.
The FDA approved Pfizer's booster for those 65 and older and certain high-risk people. Authorizations for Moderna and Johnson & Johnson boosters are likely on the way.
This work is clearly paying off.
The White House COVID-19 response team reports cases, hospitalizations, and deaths are down, but says tens of millions of unvaccinated Americans need to roll up their sleeves to continue that progress. In Washington, I'm Jesse Tenor.
All right, Jesse, thank you. Meantime, a congressman from Northeast Indiana, Republican Jim Banks, is drafting legislation to push back against the president's federal vaccine mandates.
The Constitution is clear. The president enforces the laws and Congress makes laws. And this is another gross violation of that basic constitutional principle that the Biden administration is completely ignoring.
Congressman Banks has drafted a bill that would block any requirements. Indiana AG Todd Rokita also pushing back on the mandate. Last month, President Biden announced that OSHA is developing a rule requiring all private employers with at least 100 workers to require the vaccine or weekly testing for those who don't get the shot. We could be getting more details on that soon.